Hey guys, welcome back to the stuff. This week's episode is about the first commission I've received since becoming a YouTuber. One of my good friends has a bar in his house that he built in his garage over the last year. In no way am I jealous of that. And he's asked me to build him a bar snack holder. So, of course I said yes. Two things dear to my heart, bars and snacks. So, of course I built him one. And what that looks like is this. So I'm going to be going through how I got to that, the materials I used, the processes, that sort of thing. So let's turn around and get amongst it at the workbench. Okay, so materials I'm using today to make the bar snack board are some 9mm plywood. That's going to be the base. And the rest of it is just painting clips. So I'm going to get this cut to size and then we'll have a look at those things. Okay, so I've got the basic design out, certainly in my head anyway, of how I think it will look. I've laid it out here. So what I'm going to have is the board. I'm going to put a bit of shaping on the top corners just to give it a bit more interest on the board. I'm going to have the name of the bar. So my friend, the bar is called the Gav Inn. His name is Gavin. And he's called his bar the Gav Inn. You can see what he did there. I'm then going to have these four raised areas. So these are just strips of the same 9mm ply. And on that, I'm going to put some clips that will hold the bar snacks. And then in between, I'm going to write the words crisps, nuts, snacks, and nibbles. And I think that'll be the design. Now, because I'm not very good at writing, my handwriting is terrible. I've bought some lettering stencils. So these are just sort of a plasticky lettering stencil. Bought these online for a couple of quid. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick all of this together, spray paint it all matte black, and then use white paint to transfer the letters. So these are quite flexible, so I'll be able to hold those in place while I transfer the letters. But before I do that, let's get this put together and shaped up, and then I'll get it spray painted, and then we'll have a look at the lettering.
Using just some French curves again to just get the shaping at the top, cutting that out with my jigsaw. So I'm using Type Bond 3 just to glue all these raised areas on. That give me a good solid bond, and then I'm also using some panel pins just to set those in position while it dries, and that allows me to get on with the painting, and then I fill in all of those panel pin holes with some wood filler before I let that dry before giving it a good sand.
So I've just given this one last, one final sand down. I'm pretty happy with the way this is looking. Just going to brush away some of the dust. And what I'm going to do now is apply a primer. So What I'm going to be using is this Zinsser bin. I use this to prime most things. It's really good. It's a shellac based primer, dries in about 45 minutes, and is just good stuff. So I'm going to get that on.
First coat dried. I did only put one coat on this as an undercoat, but I just gave it a sand down with some 120 and then some 180 grit sandpaper just to make the undercoat a little bit smoother before applying just some matte black spray paint.
Sprayed the board front and back, but as you can see, there's a few areas where the spray paint hasn't taken. I don't know whether that's because there was some like residual glue down there, I didn't sand enough, but what I'm gonna have to do is just go back over those with some sandpaper and respray those areas. So make sure before you spray you've prepped the area, otherwise you end up redoing it like I'm about to. So while I wait for the board to dry, so I've re-prepared it and re-sprayed it. So while I wait for that to dry, that's inside the house because it's pretty cold out in the shed, I'm just going to prepare the lettering. So I've got these sheets of letters. Now, because of the way that I'm going to apply this, doing it one letter at a time is going to take forever, because I would need to wait for the paint to dry in between each one. So what I'm actually going to do is cut these up into their constituent letters so that I can make the words, or most of the words, that I can get them done all in one go. So I'm going to give that a go now. I'm just going to cut these up into the letters I need to use. Next bit, I don't need anything off my tool wall out in the shed, so I've come inside where it's much nicer and warmer. I've repaired, paint repaired all of the bits that were didn't take a good covering earlier, sand that back, and I've given this another coat of spray paint. And as you can see, I have marked out the words, or part of the words, that I want for the that I'm going to now paint on. You'll notice that I'm missing an N up here, there's an S off the end of here, an S off the end of here, and the nib off the front of Nibbles. So I think one of the mistakes that I've made, I've bought a generic set of stencils in the hope that I could use them again in the future, but I think what I should have done was get maybe a custom stencil made that I could just peel off and stick on. This is actually a bit of a faff. I've just used painter's tape or masking tape to stick all these on, but for each of the fonts, I've only bought one sheet, therefore that S I need to use at the end. So I'm going to do this set and then take all that off and then just reset it for the next set, or the final few letters. So I'm using paint wise is some acrylic paints. I had these in my house already because I've used these for another project that I've done in the past. I'm just using black and white, so I'm going to have white text, but what I'm going to be doing is applying black first to try and get a seal around the edges, because what I'm expecting is there'll be a bit of bleed out because I haven't maybe stuck down all of the letters, like, because it's not a vinyl stick or I haven't used any adhesive. I maybe am expecting a bit of bleed out along the edges of the letters, and my hope is by going over in black first and letting that dry, that'll essentially seal the letters and then I use the white afterwards once that's dried. I'm going to be applying the paint with a sponge and I'll be dabbing that in. This was a top tip from one of my subscribers, so thanks Jade for that top tip. I've tested it out and it seems to work brilliantly. So this is just a sponge that I use to do the dishes. Normally I just cut a bit off. You can use a makeup sponge if you've got one, just whatever you've got in the house. So I'm gonna get some paint on and see how that comes out. Okay, these have now dried, so I guess moment of truth, I'm going to peel these off, see how they've come out. Fingers crossed. I'm a little bit worried about this one in the middle. I think the stencil on that was a little bit more flimsy than the others maybe, but we'll see. So let's get these peeled off. Okay, so they actually came out relatively well. I've got a little bit of bleeding on the edge of the eye and the R there, and like a few of the other letters, I mean the bottom of the N there, but overall I am really pleased about that. You'll notice I've got this bit in between the N there. That was where I had just stuck the bit down, so I'm just gonna try and paint that in. And I've got another bit of bleed out there in the S, which I'm just going to try and get a little paintbrush and just tidy that up. But what I'm going to do now is finish off the lettering, and then we're pretty much done. So paint is all dry now. I think the lettering's turned out really well. I think some of the spacing's a little bit. Could have probably been a little bit better, but overall really pleased with the way this looks. What I have done is put a clear lacquer on it. Didn't film that bit, but essentially just a clear spray lacquer. I've put that over the top just to give it a bit of extra protection. Final thing, or second to last thing I'm going to do is put somewhere to hang the snacks. And what I've got is some bulldog clips. These are sort of a copper red brushed finish, and I'm just going to be putting those on the board on these raised bits, and I'll be attaching those using some pan head screws, so I'm going to get those on. And then we're nearly done. The very last thing I'm gonna do is these holes that I drilled, I'm just gonna put a rope handle through. I'm actually gonna need to cut a longer bit of rope than this. I've cut this way too short, but I'll have a knot on both ends and that'll allow it to be hung on the wall. So there we have it. That is a snack board. So, end of another day here on Mad Dad's Stuff. Really enjoyed the build this weekend. Some of the processes I've never done before, but really pleased with the way that the snack board turned out, and there's a legit good excuse to buy some of my favourite snacks. And to accompany that, I'm going to celebrate with a beer. And this week, I'm drinking a Zulu Alpha Holdy Haze. So this is brewed by a chap I work with. If you're ever around the Caldicot area over in Wales, check him out. Really good stuff. Oh yeah, nice brew that. Right, see you next time. And remember, you stay safe, get some stuff done.